Imagine a little screen on your desk, wall, or even your fridge, quietly updating you with your calendar, to-do list, or the weather, without the distractions of a mobile phone or computer. That's what TRMNL is, a sleek open-source battery-powered e-ink display that's built to be simple, low-power, and easy to use. Today I'll show you what the ready-made TRMNL can do, and then we'll go a step further and actually build one ourselves from scratch to see if it's worth making your own or buying their pre-made version. This is the TRMNL package that you can order directly from their website for $139. They also have a few different finishes and some add-ons like a battery upgrade or a developer license to create your own plugins. I've got the Clarity Kit, which includes the developer license, a USB-C charging cable, a screen protector, and then the TRMNL itself, which has the upgraded 2500mAh battery. This is the grey version and it comes in a total of 6 different colours. On the front we've got the 7.5-inch e-ink display, and on the back is the power switch, a button to refresh the screen, and a USB-C port for charging. It's also got two mounting options, a hanging point for a nail or screw, and then a flip-out metal stand. I kinda wish it had a magnetic option as well. This would make it easy to stick onto a fridge or filing cabinet. The device is pre-assembled and ready to go, with their software already installed. I found the setup process really easy to work through. You essentially connect to the TRMNL's Wi-Fi hotspot to tell it how to connect to your Wi-Fi network, and then link it to your account using its device ID. After linking to your account, it automatically updates the firmware, and the rest is then managed through their website. One of the best features of TRMNL is that because it's got an e-ink display and a low-power microcontroller, it doesn't need to be permanently plugged in. The built-in battery will keep it powered for up to 6 months between charges, obviously depending on how often it's updating the display. Being an e-ink display, it only requires power to change the image. Between updates, the display is off and the microcontroller goes into a low-power sleep mode. Their website's fairly easy to use once you get the hang of it, but it can be a bit confusing when you first open it up. There are basically 3 components to what is displayed. You've got playlists, plugins, and recipes. Plugins and recipes are essentially the apps that provide the content to be displayed. Plugins are those developed by TRMNL themselves, and recipes are the community developed ones. You then load these into a playlist which allows you to cycle through them so that you're not just limited to running one app at a time. There are a few other options, like you can have up to 4 plugins or recipes displayed at once through one of the 8 available layouts, so you can really get quite a lot of information onto it. At the time of making this video, there are over 400 plugins and recipes available for TRMNL, so you should easily be able to tailor it to your needs. This is not an LCD or OLED display, so you're not getting an HD quality image, and the highest refresh rate that you can set is once every 5 minutes. It's intended to be a minimalistic display for data that doesn't change very quickly or often, and that will run for a few months between charges. You can even set it to only update once every hour, and enable sleep mode during times when you're not around it anyway, and that'll extend battery life to over 10 months. You can use it to display images, and there are a couple of plugins for images which get the job done, but it's not what this screen is intended to be used for. The rendered image is quite grainy. It's far better suited to displaying sharp text and simple graphics. Another useful feature is the ability to schedule plugins for a certain time of day. Like you could display the weather and calendar in the morning, and then automatically switch to a to-do list during your workday. Now let's move on to the DIY version. Since the team behind TRMNL have made it completely open source, they've also published everything you need to build your own version, and you can register DIY devices on their server to use their web platform too. They say that their retail price is often cheaper than building your own, and that may be true depending on where you get your components, but I found mine to be a tiny bit cheaper. I managed to get a 7.5-inch e-ink display, a tiny ESP32 with antenna, a display breakout board with a built-in battery charger, and a similarly sized 2000mAh battery, all for just $55, which landed up being $70 including shipping. So this is quite a bit cheaper than TRMNL's $139 price tag. But that's before adding their $50 one-time device fee to use their server. And it's also without an enclosure, which I'm going to design and 3D print myself. So all up, I think it's fair to say that you'll be in for a similar price either way. You also don't have to pay the $50 to use their server. You can host your own server privately. This will do away with the device fee, as well as keep all of your data in-house if you'd like to. I quite like the ease of use of their website, and I'd rather pay a one-off fee than have to pay a monthly subscription, so I'm glad they've gone with this model. The heart of the DIY terminal is this tiny ESP32 module. This is a 32-bit RISC-V chip that operates at up to 160 MHz, but its real strength is its low power consumption. It can use as little as 44 microamps in deep sleep mode, which makes it perfect for this type of battery-powered project. It's also got built-in 2.4 GHz Wi-Fi and Bluetooth 5. The 7.5-inch display that we're pairing it with has a resolution of 800x480, and it takes around 3.5 seconds for a full refresh of a single frame, so it's not winning any awards on the performance side. But like the ESP32, it's really good on power consumption. It uses just 8 milliamps during a refresh, and it doesn't need any power between refreshes to maintain what is displayed. To connect these both together, as well as use and charge the battery, we've got an e-paper driver board. This has a 24-pin FPC connector for the display, a socket for the ESP32, a charging circuit and port for the battery, and then a power switch on the side. Because of the components I've chosen, there isn't a whole lot to build. All of the components just plug into the driver board. Next, we need a flash terminal's firmware onto it, and there's a couple of options for this depending on the hardware you're using. These vary in complexity from using a simple web tool to having to build the firmware from source code. Once that's done, you follow a similar process as before to pair it to your account, and then you can start creating playlists. I measured up the electronic components and designed a simple 3D printed enclosure for them. I wanted to make something a little different to the original terminal housing, so I went with this design, which looks like it's holding the e-paper display a bit like a sheet of paper or card, really highlighting how thin it is while also sticking with the minimalistic theme. The electronics are then all stored in the base. So let's get it printed out. To finish it off, we just need to install some brass inserts in the base for the M2.5 screws to screw into. We can then install the display, ESP32 and the battery, stick the antenna on the inside of the enclosure, and then close it up. We've now got a unique DIY terminal which provides similar functionality to the original. So that's TRMNL, a minimalist smart display that you can either buy ready to go or build yourself. Personally, I love that it strips away the noise and just gives you the information you actually want and when you need it. If you want to check it out, I've linked TRMNL's website in the video description, along with my 3D printed enclosure design and all of the hardware I used for the DIY version. I'd love to hear what you'd use TRMNL for and what you think of my DIY version, so let me know in the comment section below. If you enjoyed this project, please leave a like and consider subscribing so you don't miss the next one. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.